Hello friends and welcome to the Physio Voice. Today we are going to discuss about training of reach to grasp in stroke patients. Approximately 50% of stroke survivors experience considerable disability of arm and hand function which persist for the rest of their lives. Physiotherapy techniques which are impairment oriented, for example decreasing the spasticity, may not always work as they do not lead to consecutive improvement in patients' activities of daily living. Rather, task-specific training or task-oriented training has been proven to be more beneficial as it involves practicing a specific task, keeping in mind the patient's existing functional capabilities, patient's individual preferences, in context of patient's home environment and the amount of carer support available. The most relevant task-specific training for the upper limb would appear to be reach-to-grasp movements, as these movements are essential for everyday functions and are used more frequently than other upper limb movements. When practicing reach-to-grasp movements, three aspects are important. First is the material of the task, that is, the object to be grasped and its characteristics. Second is how meaningful is the activity for the patient. And third, the social situation in which the activity has to be performed. Let us now discuss why the presence of an object and its characteristics are relevant for reach to grasp movements. Suppose I have to reach for this glass of water. As soon as I initiate my reach, my hand opens based on the visual information that I am receiving from the object. Throughout my reach, my hand aperture will start to form and get modified continuously based on the characteristics of the object. Just before grasping, my hand aperture closes so that I get an accurate grasp. This is how important visual feedback regarding the presence of an object is. So in everyday life, even if suppose the glass is unexpectedly perturbed or its position is changed, I'll still be able to grasp it correctly based on the visual input I'm getting. The same rule applies for therapy. In task-specific training, making the patient do a meaningful task which he has already performed thousands of times is already centrally programmed in his brain, thus making his neuromuscular system more efficient to perform the task. Also, the patient is able to perceive sensory information about the layout of performance context, meaning the patient can see where the object is placed at what height and in relation to his own body can assess the distance between his hand and the object, thus making the task and the effort easier. Lastly, it decreases the effort it takes for the patient to imagine a location or a target in space. To conclude, let's summarize the key points from today's video. Reach to grasp training is more efficient when done in the presence of an object as opposed to an imaginary object. The object characteristics matter, so make the patient practice with multiple objects depending on the patient's functional goals. For example, glass to drink water from, bottle to pour water into the glass, toothbrush and toothpaste for brushing of teeth, etc. Also, the patient might use the objects at different height and at different places in his house, so make sure the practice is done in various contexts. And lastly, make sure the patient practices at home with maximum repetitions for the best results. Thank you. Do like, comment and share and subscribe to our channel, The Physio Voice.